couple of weeks ago, we did a video on the rapid decline of the career of Chelsea Handler. Chelsea Handler is one of those comedians that never makes anyone laugh. To be honest with you, I'm surprised her career's lasted as long as it has. When you're a comedian, you only have one job requirement. Be funny. Make people laugh. That's it. If you're working as a janitor, your only job requirement is to keep everything clean. The bathroom's consistently dirty. There's always trash on the floor. You're not going to be a janitor for long. Besides her appearance, there's nothing funny about Chelsea Handler, which is why it confused me a couple of weeks ago when she was being considered to be given yet another opportunity to fail in late night comedy. During the Chelsea Handler video, I briefly mentioned another huge embarrassing failure in late night television, who somehow miraculously lasted for 7 years. Not only did she last 7 years, she won a fucking Emmy. I guess all you have to do to win an Emmy in late night comedy these days is make fun of Donald Trump and prep yourself for cucumber penetration. For the better part of 7 years, Samantha Bee has been the biggest huge embarrassing failure in late night television. Last September, TBS announced they were going to renew Full Cucumber with Samantha Bee for a 7th season. Now this confused many in the industry because the 2 weeks prior to renewal, she once again found herself in her usual position in the late night standings, dead fucking last. What was even funnier about it, and this might be the funniest thing to ever be associated with Full Cucumber, was the press release TBS sent out about renewing the garbage. Samantha Bee is a trailblazer for women who closely resemble men. Her show consistently averages 2.5 million viewers. What? 2.5 million viewers? You could add up the ratings for the wokest shitfucks in late night. Don Lemon, Jimmy Kimmel, Honey Bee, and still not reach 2.5 million viewers. I gotta give credit to TBS. That was some great comedy. For the first time in 7 years, people actually laughed at something associated with Full Cucumber. I've pointed this out several times in the past because it shows the true bias in television. HBO canceled Bill Simmons several years ago because he was averaging 400,000 or 500,000 viewers. But someone like Bomani Jones or Honey Bee can't attract trash to the local dump, and they're given endless opportunities. Don't worry about those pesky ratings. We know people aren't watching. We just need you to keep pushing this propaganda to the 11 virgins on Twitter who care. But alas, all shitty things must come to an end. You can't allow one person to dwell in the ratings basement forever. Eventually, they have to give up their space to another useless shitfuck. Earlier today, TBS announced they were canceling Full Cucumber with Samantha Bee. TBS claimed that this was a difficult business decision, but Honey Bee doesn't align with our new programming strategy. What is the new programming strategy at TBS? Airing shows people will actually watch. Full Cucumber has been a ratings disaster for the last several years. During the Trump administration, most late-night shows experienced dramatic increases in ratings. Bashing Donald Trump was entertaining television. Not Samantha Bee. No. Now, don't get me wrong. Her show consisted of nothing but Orange Man Bad. But for some reason, while her colleagues were drawing millions of viewers, Samantha Bee couldn't attract her fellow bees to fresh honey. I wonder why. I wonder if this had anything to do with it.
Do something about your dad's immigration practices, you feckless cunt.
As it turns out, the majority of women don't find it funny or entertaining when a woman who closely resembles a man calls another woman a feckless cunt. Ratings dropped 29%, with ratings in the 18 to 49 demo declining by 34%. From 2017 to 2018, Samantha Bee lost almost half her audience. Now imagine for a second that Greg Gutfeld called Jill Biden a feckless cunt. How long would his show remain on Fox News? They would be forced to cancel him because they wouldn't be able to find advertisers. Yet for some reason, Samantha Bee remained on the air another 4 years. I was only able to find 2 advertisers that pulled out of sponsoring her show after that. Auto Trader, State Farm. The rest of the advertisers stuck by her. We are committed to getting the orange fungus out of the White House. The work of Samantha Bee is far too important to distance ourselves over a minor mistake like this. Yeah, minor mistake. When members of Woke United Methodists make mistakes, it's minor. When the rest of us make mistakes or offend someone by using the wrong pronoun, we get life without parole. Now, I am never one that supports the silencing of free speech. Do I think Samantha Bee should have been thrown off the air for what she said about Donald Trump's daughter? No. I think she should have been off the air years ago for her inability to draw an audience. I pulled the ratings for her most recent shows. Season finale last month drew 463,000. The week before, 285,000. 2 weeks before that, failed to crack the top 150 on cable. Back in April, Samantha Bee made some remarks that highlighted the real problem in late-night television. I know this is hard to believe for my younger audience, but late-night comedians, they actually used to be funny. They were funny because they weren't agenda-driven. It didn't matter if there was a Republican or Democrat in the White House, they were getting roasted every night on late-night television. I can remember when the Bill Clinton-Monica Lewinsky scandal broke out in the late 90s. It provided content on late-night shows for 2 years. George Bush was elected. He got it just as bad, if not worse, than Bill Clinton did. But things began to shift in late night when Barack Obama was in office, more specifically during his second term. Not only was there a generational shift, both Leno and Letterman passed the torch to Jimmy Fallon and Stephen Colbert, but there was a mentality shift. The focus shifted from entertaining people, from making people laugh, to lecturing the audience on the host's woke political beliefs. Late-night comedians began chasing cucumbers instead of chasing laughter. They wouldn't joke about certain issues because they were worried about offending people. Comedy at its core is about walking that fine line between being offensive and being funny. That's what comedy is. Back in April, Samantha Bee admitted that she doesn't feel right making fun of Joe Biden the same way she made fun of Donald Trump. She said, "Why would I want to undermine someone I love and support? I don't need to make jokes just to be funny. I only make targeted jokes." Let me translate that woke bullshit for you. I am willing to alienate half the country to make sure I'm still invited to the butt bongo fiesta. To her credit, her philosophy worked. Instead of making jokes about everyone, Samantha Bee made targeted jokes and no one watched her show. Let me give you a brief example of some of her comedy. Roll the film.
Republicans want to control our bodies, and by overturning Roe, they succeed. There are now three generations who don't understand what life was like in a world without Roe. They weren't around to see the desperation that drove hundreds of thousands of American women to get illegal abortions, many of which were self-induced.
What does justice look like when all of this is done?
Justice is subjective, honestly, because what kind of justice can I deliver to Breonna Taylor's family, to Tony McDade's family, to George Floyd's family, to Ahmaud Arbery? Justice would be them still being alive.
Right.
But we can do everything in our power with the stroke of a pen and the political will and courage to make sure that doesn't happen again.
What does the America you want look like?
Instead of school police, there would be social workers, therapists, restorative justice practices, that we center the humanity and the dignity of people.
People living free from fear?
Free from fear.
Children playing outside?
Free from fear.
Reminds me of the suburbs in a way.
Oh, I can't contain my laughter. Nothing makes me laugh like two women who look like men complaining about mythical racism. Ha 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 ha. Seriously, did any of you find that funny? Did that resemble a late night talk show to you? It looked more like something you would find on fucking PBS at 11 o'clock in the morning. It's no wonder this show was a failure. Woke shitfucks like to claim Samantha Bee is a trailblazer for women in late night. But the truth is, she's the complete opposite. In order to be a trailblazer, you have to succeed. How many losers are we going to label as trailblazers? You want a trailblazer in comedy for women? Look at Joan Rivers. Her career took off at a time when stand-up comedy was dominated by men. But even Joan Rivers couldn't succeed in late-night television. It is a male-dominated landscape for a reason. That's what people want to watch. Chelsea Handler, failure. Samantha Bee, failure. Now, does it mean a woman will never succeed in late night? No, but they've tried this experiment 3 times, and none of the 3 ever stood the test of time. Now, who knows where Samantha Bee goes from here? Hopefully, she goes back home to Canada, where she can not entertain Canadians instead of not entertaining us here in America. Maybe TBS will give her a time slot to Chelsea Handler. Hell, she can do a segment every week with Samantha Bee. Chelsea and the Bee worship the oak tree. Well, let me know what you think. Loyal comrade Samantha Bee, who ties 30% of her income to Woke United Methodist, is being forced to return her cucumber. Did any of you guys ever watch this garbage? I thought the best thing she ever did was that mock White House Correspondents' Dinner. I think it was back in 2017. And the only reason that was good was because Will Ferrell impersonated George Bush. Other than that, this show was WNBA-level garbage. But let me know. Sound off in the comments below. Make sure to like and subscribe. Click the notification bell to receive all notifications from the channel. Best way to contact me is by email at btlkc84@gmail.com. KC_btl84 on Twitter. I'll see you guys tomorrow.